Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Bhagavad Gita as it is, translation and commentary by His Divine Grace, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, founder Acharya of ISKCON.
Bhagavad Gita kako jest, prevod je komentar na njegove božanske milosti A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, Acharya osnivača ISKCON.
Founder
Acharya. Acharya ISKCON.
Chapter 12, texts 13 and 14. Advishta sarva bhutanam maitra karuna evacha nirmamo nirahamkara samadukha sukakshami santushta satatam yogi yatatma dhranischayaha mayarbita manu buddhir yomad bhakta same priyaha.
Dakle, 12. poglavlje, stihovi 13 i 14. Moj bhakta ko nije zavedan, već je ljubazan prijatelj svih živih bića, ko ne misli da vlasnika i ko nema lažni ego, koji je jednak i u sreći i u nesreći, koji je smošljiv, uvijek zadovoljan, samovladan i koji me odlično predano služi, umo i inteligencija usredotočenih na mene, veoma mi je drag. Smisao. Došavši ponovo do čistoga predanog služenja, gospodin u ova dva stiha opisuje transcendentalne osobine čistoga bhakte. Čisti bhakta nikada ni u kakvim okolnostima nije uznemiren, niti ikome zavidi. Nije neprijatelj svom neprijatelju, već misli. Ova se osoba ophodi neprijateljski prema meni zbog mojih prošlih nedjela. Zato bolje da ispaštam nego da prosjedujem. U Šrimad Bhagavatamu 10.14.8 rečeno je Tate nokam param susa mikšaman šamano bunđana evatma kritam vipakam. Kad god se bhakta nađe u teškom stanju ili u nevolji, smatra to gospodinovom milošću. On misli, zbog nedjela koje sam počinio u prošlosti, trebao bih mnogo više patiti nego što sada patim. Milošću svevišnjeg gospodina ne dobijam su tu kaznu koju zaslužujem. Zahvaljujući milosti svevišnje božanske osobe, dobijam samo mali dio. Zato je tih miran i strpnih unatoč brojnim nevoljama. Bhakta uvijek ljubaza prema svakome, čak i prema svom neprijatelji. Nirmana znači da ne pridaje veliku važnost bolovima i problemima vezanim uz tijelo, jer savršeno dobro zna da nije materijalno tijelo, ne prostovječuje se s tijelom. Zato oslobođuje koncepcije lažnog ega i smiren i u sreći i u nesreći, smošljiv i zadovoljan svime što dođe milošću svevišnjega gospodina. Ne trudi se da nešto postigne uz velik napor, zato uvijek radostan. Savršen je mistik jer potpuno slijedi upute svoga duhovnog učitelja. Budući da vlada osjetljivo odlučanje, lažni argumenti ne zavode, jer ga nitko ne može odraditi od čvrste odluke da predano služi. Potpuno je svjestan da je Krišna vječni gospodin i zato ga nitko ne može uznemiriti. Sve te osobine omogućuju mu da svoj um i inteligenciju potpuno sredotoči na svevišnjega gospodina. Takav standard predanog služenja nedvojbeno je vrlo rijedak. No bhakta ga dostiže sljedeći propisana načela predanog služenja. Gospodin izjavlja da mu je takav bhakta veoma drag, jer je gospodin uvijek zadovoljan svim njegovim djelatnostima koje vrši u potpunoj svjesnosti Krišne.
Krishna is naturally full of all good qualities.
Krishna je zapravo pun svih dobrih odlika.
In Nectar of Devotion, Bhaktivedanta Sindhu, Rupa Goswami has listed 56 qualifications of Krishna by which he is attractive to everybody.
U Nektaru prevodnosti Bhaktira Samrita Sindhu, Rupa Goswami navodi 56 krišnjenih karakteristika ili odlika kojima sve privlači.
So a devotee also becomes decorated with good qualities.
Bhakta također postaje ukrašen dobrim odlikama.
Yes, yasti bhakti bhagavate kinchana sarvai gunais tatra samasati sura. All the good qualities of the demigods automatically appear in the person of a devotee.
Sve dobre odlike polubogova automatski se javljaju u osobi bhakte.
What kind of devotee? Akinchan. Yes, yasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana. One who is akinchan.
U kakvoj vrsti bhakte? U bhakti koji je akinchana.
Akinchan means he has nothing in this world, only Krishna.
Akinchana znači da ne posjeduje ništa na ovom svijetu, samo Krishna.
Krishna's one name is Akinchana Gochara. He is revealed to those who have no other desire but to serve him.
Jedno od Krishnih imena je Akinchana Gochara, što znači da on da, da
Krishna reveals.
Да се Кришна разоткрива само онима кои не посудува ништа осим Него, жели да го служи.
Krishna, these qualities, they are attractive. Therefore, his name is Krishna, all attractive.
Ова Кришна не одлеке се врло привлачен, избор тука се назива Кришна или се привлачен.
Those qualities have been described as they, those qualities as they develop in devotees have been described by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Како се те одлеке развија бхакти, описува Шри Чайтанја Махапрабху.
And a devotee is kind.
Бхакта е љубазен.
Merciful.
Милостив.
Clean.
Чист.
Tolerant.
Трпелив.
Balanced eater.
Уравнотежено јадење.
Poetic.
Песник.
Compassionate.
Сосјечаен.
The most important of all these qualities is Krishna Ikasharan. He's completely surrendered to Krishna.
Најбитна од сите овие одлики е да е потпуно предан Кришни.
And by that surrender, all the qualities develop.
И тоа предам у него се развија се добри одлики.
Because Krishna is the ocean of all the qualities.
Јер е Кришна океан сите добри одлики.
That's called Gunanava, an ocean of transcendental qualities.
Тоа се назива Гунарнава, океан сите добри одлики.
Prabhatasya Kalyana Gunarnavasya. The spiritual master is getting benediction from the ocean of good qualities.
То пеамо јутре да духовни учител прима благослови из оцеана милости.
Someone can bring some water. So it is natural for the living being to have all good qualities.
За живо биће природно да има све добре одлике.
Because he is part and parcel of Krishna.
Јер је он одјелећи честица Кришне.
So when we revive our Krishna consciousness, those good qualities come out.
И када поново оживимо своје свјесност Кришне, те се одлике поново појавили.
At the moment, these good qualities, they are covered.
У овом тренутку, те одлике су прикривене.
And perverted.
И запачене.
As lust.
У облику пожуде.
Envy.
Зависти.
Anger.
Бјеса.
Greed.
Похлепе.
These are described by Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita.
Njih opisuje gospodin Krishna u Bhagavad Gita.
Dambho darpo vimanas cha, krodha parisham eva cha, agyana cha vijatasya partha sambhadam asurim. Those who are demoniac, they have all bad qualities.
Oni koji su demonske prirode imaju sve loše odlike.
Pride.
Ponos.
Conceit.
Mišljenost.
Arrogance.
Arrogantnost.
False ego.
Lažan ego.
Ignorance.
Neznanje.
Harsh speech.
Grub govor.
These all are present in the personalities of demons.
Svi oni su prisutni u osobi, u ličnosti demona.
But actually we're not meant to be demons, we're meant to be devotees, every living being.
Но меѓутим ние нисмо намерени тоа да бидеме демони, веќе бхакте и тако е со сакам живим бичем.
But that love for Krishna, which is our inherent nature, which is very strong.
Але таа љубов према Кришни, која е запро наша уродена природа, која е врло снажна.
It becomes perverted into all bad qualities.
Постае изопачено се лоши одлики.
And therefore we cause suffering to others and suffering to ourselves.
И бидејќи тоа наносиме патња другима и себи.
And Krishna is also not pleased to see this.
И Кришна такоје не е задоволен што тоа види.
Krishna says here that a devotee who has developed all good qualities is very dear to me.
Кришна ја каже, бхакта кој развија се добри одлики, веома ми е драг.
So similarly, Krishna is not very pleased to see that his devotees they've become demons and are acting wrongly.
Значи тоа Кришна не воле видеть да се негови бхакти претварају у демони.
Those who are very demoniac, they take pleasure in very nasty activities.
Оние кои имају демонски менталитет bave se vrlo ogavnim djelatnostima.
This was very much demonstrated in the recent war in Bosnia.
To se je jako lijepo prikazano u nedavnom ratu u Bosni.
And you'll see, just like in Spain, they have this bull fighting. They take pleasure in torturing the bull and killing him.
I vidjet ćete kao što u Španjolskoj postoje borbe s bikovima, gdje oni zapravo uživaju u tome da se da muče bika i ubijaju ga.
But generally most of the people in the world they don't approve of this kind of thing.
Međutim, većina ljudi u svijetu ne odobrava takve stvari.
They express horror at the atrocities performed in the war in Bosnia, for instance.
Oni izražavaju svoje negodovanje, svoje gađanje sa groznim stvarima koje su se događale u Bosni.
It is somewhat hypocritical because at the same time they're eating meat. which is obtained by torturing animals and then killing them.
Koje se dobija od toga što se životinje muče, a zatim ubijaju.
Especially now they have all these mechanized, they have these factory farms.
Znači, sada kad imaju sve te mehanizirane tvornice, farme.
Where throughout
the, takva okrutnost.
At least they give lip service to grossly horrible activities.
Makar prekoravaju takve djelatnosti.
Prabhupada, he wrote that most of the people in the world are not bad.
Prabhupada napisao da većina ljudi u svijetu nije zapravo loša.
They're not so bad by nature.
Po svoj prirodi oni nisu tako loši.
Of course, everyone in this world is bad, otherwise why are we here?
Naravno, svi u svijetu su loši, zašto bismo inače bili ovdje?
But most of the people, they're not so very, very demonic.
No, većina ljudi u ovom svijetu nije tako jako, jako demonska.
Most of the people are innocent but misled.
Većina ljudi je nevina, ali zavedena na pogrešni put.
Mostly the leaders are bad.
Uglavnom su vođe loše.
Because the leaders of society are influencing people to become demoniac more and more.
Jer vođe društva utječu na ljude da postaje sve više i više demonske prirode.
We see, actually, if you see mostly children, you can very easily get them to chant Hare Krishna.
Vidjet ćete da je djecu vrlo lako natjerati da pjevaju Hare Krishna.
Do you have that experience here?
Imate to iskustvo?
But when they get a little older, then it becomes more difficult.
No, kad postanu stariji, postaje teže.
Because they've been trained in a different way.
Jer su vježbani na drugačiji način.
Then they get the idea that how we should live as perfectly civilized demons.
Tada dobiju ideju o tome kako treba živjeti kao potpuno civilizirani demoni.
But still most people, they're not sober.
Ali šulik, većina ljudi nije tako loša.
If the propaganda for demoniac life was not so strong, then certainly many people could come to Krishna consciousness.
Kada propaganda za demonski život nije bila tako snažna, sigurno bi mnogo ljudi moglo doći do svjesnosti Krishne.
And although people tend to get misled by false kind of propaganda about our movement in the newspapers.
I mada ljudi ne laze na razne vrste loše propagande po novinama o nama.
Still, when people come in contact with devotees, they can see how we are living. They come, many people appreciate it.
Još uvijek kada dođu u dodir sa baktama, mogu vidjeti kako žive i to cijene.
Devotees are not ordinary people.
Bakte nisu obični ljudi.
It's not only in our dress that we are different.
Mi se ne razlikujemo samo po svojoj odjeći.
Hopefully our dress is different.
Srećom naša odjeća jeste različita.
It's better to dress as devotees so people can see.
Bolje se djelati kao bhakti, tako da ljudi to mogu vidjeti.
This is a devotee of Krishna.
Ovo je Krishnin bhakta.
And in the beginning they may laugh a little.
I u početku se mogu malo smijati.
They may do, they may not.
A može se ne treba smijati.
Probably most people are surprised when they first see devotees dressed like this.
Vjerojatno većina ljudi iznenađena kad vidi tako obučene bhakte.
But after some time they get used to it and they see it so many times. Then they become... Especially now so many people in Western Europe, America, Australia.
Naročito sada puno ljudi u zapadnoj Europi, Americi, Australiji.
When they were 3 or 4 years old, they were going with their mother in the city center. They used to see devotees chanting and dancing.
Kada su imali oko 3 godine, išli bi sa svojim majkama po središtu grada i vidjeli bakte kako plešu, pjeve na ulici.
So now when they're 23 years old, they don't think it's unusual. They've seen it all their lives.
I sada kada ima 23 godine, ne smatraju to jako neobičnim jer su to gledali cijeli svoj život.
So when people see devotees, they know this is a member of Hare Krishna.
To je kad ljudi vide bhaktu i kaže da, to je član Hare Krishna pokreta.
Just by thinking Hare Krishna, there's some purification to them.
Čak i kad samo pomisle Hare Krishna, oni se pročišćavaju.
Just by seeing a devotee, there's some purification.
Samo kad vide bhaktu, dolazi do nekog pročišćenja.
Now, how do people think of our devotees?
Da, kako ljudi misle o našim bhaktama?
Mostly they pick up some ideas which they get in the newspapers or whatever.
Većinom prihvaćaju neke ideje koje nađu u novinama.
But if they meet our devotees and they appreciate what good character they have, that will be very good preaching.
No, ako se susretnu s našim baktama i vide kako divne osobine, kako divan karakter oni imaju, to će biti jako dobro propovjedanje.
We want to establish Krishna consciousness in this world.
Želimo učvrstiti svjetnost Krishna u ovom svijetu.
How is that to be done?
Kako se to može učiniti?
We have book distribution.
Imamo deljenje knjiga.
Prabhupada said, know it for certain that there is no better way to preach, to spread Krishna consciousness than by distributing my books.
Шри Прабхупада рекол, знаете, засигурно да не постои никакав бољ начин проповедање од делење мојих книга. Имамо фестивали, делење прасадама,
Харинам Санкиртан.
Харинам Санкиртан.
There are so many programs for bringing people to Krishna consciousness.
Постои толико многу програми за доводење луѓе у свесност Кришна.
One very important thing is just how the devotees behave with the public.
Jedan od važnih stvari je kako se bhakta ponaša prema javnosti.
And with each other.
I jedni prema drugima.
Chaitanya Charitamrita has stated, dharma sthapan hetu shadu bebaha. Religion is established in this world by the behavior of saintly people.
U Chaitanya Charitamrita je rečeno da se religija u ovom svijetu učvršćuje na temelju vladanja svetih osoba.
People expect good behavior from saintly people.
Ljudi očekuju dobro ponašanje od svetih ljudi.
Saintly people are supposed to be like shelters for those who are suffering in material life.
Sveti ljudi trebaju biti nešto poput utočišta za osobe koje pate u materijalnom svijetu.
Generally people approach saintly people when they're experiencing some distress.
Ljudi uglavnom prolaze sa svetim osobama kada prolaze kroz neke nevolje.
So, because a saintly person is full in himself.
Jer je sveta osoba potpuna u sebi.
Here Krishna stated, sama dukha sukha kshami. He's unaffected by the happiness and misery of this material world.
Ovdje Krishna kaže da na njega ne utječu sreće i nesreće ovog svijeta.
Undisturbed.
Nije njemu uznemiren.
By the comings and goings of this world.
Nije uznemiren djelatnostima ovog svijeta.
Because his senses are controlled.
Jer su njegova svjetila kontrolirana.
Therefore he's able to deal equally with everybody.
Stoga se može obhoditi jednako prema svakome.
Advishta sarva bhutanam maitra karuna evacha. He's not envious of anybody.
On nikome ne zavidi.
He's friendly and merciful to everybody.
Prijatelje i milostivi prema svima.
Because he doesn't see anyone as his enemy.
Jer nikoga ne vidi kao svog neprijatelja.
Even if someone does become an enemy of a devotee.
Čak i ako netko postane bhaktin neprijatelj.
A devotee never becomes an enemy of anybody else.
Bhakta nikad ne postaje neprijatelj bilo koga drugoga.
Of course in preaching we have so many philosophical enemies.
Naravno, u propovjedanju imamo mnogo filozofskih neprijatelja.
And sometimes we speak in very strong terms against them.
I ponekad vrlo snažno govorimo protiv njih.
But we don't hate anyone.
Ali nikoga ne mrzimo.
Vaishnav, he never feels hatred towards anybody.
Vaishnava nikad ne osjeća mržnju ni prema kome.
Vaishnava feels love for everybody.
Vaishnava osjeća ljubav za svakoga.
Because he loves Krishna.
Jer voli Krishnu.
And he knows that everyone is part and parcel of Krishna.
I zna da je svako Krishnin dijelić i čestica.
So even if someone is behaving very wrongly.
I čak ako se netko jako pogrešno ponaša.
The Vaishnava may speak very strongly.
Vaishnava može jako snažno govoriti.
That is not hatred.
Ali to nije mržnja.
Just like the mother chastises the child.
Kao što majka kori svoje dijete.
To correct the child.
Kako bi ga ispravila.
Not out of hate.
A ne iz mržnje.
Srila Prabhupada told one story.
Srila Prabhupada je ispričao jednu priču.
When he was living in Calcutta.
Dok je živio u Calcutta kao kuće vlasnik.
One morning he heard a big commotion from next door.
Jedno jutro čuje veliko uznemirenje koje dolazilo od susjednih vrata.
The young lady, one of the young ladies living there was shouting and her child was crying.
Jedna od mladih dama koja tamo živjela vikala na svoje dijete koje je plakala.
So there's a system of that if you want to find out what's going in the next house, you send your servant and he asks the servant in the next house and he comes back and brings the information.
Postoji sistem, ako želite saznati što se događa u drugoj kući, taj da pošaljete svog slugu kako bi upitao slugu iz druge kuće što se događa i tako da bi informacije.
So what had happened, this woman had several sons.
Dovodilo se to da ova žena imala nekoliko sinova.
One of them had typhoid.
A jedan od njih je imao tifus.
Typhoid is such a disease that you should not eat at all.
Tifus je takva bolest da uopće ne bi smjela jesti.
If you eat, it's very dangerous.
Jako je opasno ako bilo što pojedete.
Fever will increase more and more.
Temperatura će se sve više i više povećavati.
So, the boy who had typhoid, he said secretly to one of his brothers, Just get me something to eat.
Taj dječak koji ima tifus, potajice je rekao svom bratu, donesi mi bilo što da pojedem.
So that boy had secretly given him some paratas.
I taj dječak mu je kradomice dao neke parate.
You know what parate is?
Znate li što su parate?
Some kind of fried bread.
To je nešto kao prženi kruh.
So then the mother found out.
I onda majka to saznala.
She was very angry.
I bila je vrlo ljuta.
She was shouting at her, the boy who had done the stealing and given to the Swiss brother.
Vikala je dječaka koji je to ukrao i dao sam bratu.
So there are so many cases. The mother will chastise the child.
I postoji mnogo slučajeva u kojima će majka koriti svoje dijete.
But that is not out of bad feeling.
Ali to nije zbog lošeg osjećaja.
So in Krishna consciousness it is required that we speak very strongly and preach very strongly.
U svjetnosti Krišne nužno je da snažno govorimo i snažno propovjedamo.
But that is not hatred.
Ali to nije mržnja.
Devotee is the kind friend of everybody.
Bhakta ljubazan prijatelj svih živih bića.
At the same time it should be understood that being the kind friend of everybody doesn't mean that he is a wet sentimentalist.
Istovremeno moramo shvatiti da to znači da on da to ne znači da je on neki mokri sentimentalist.
Sometimes we see pictures of swamis holding a flower and smiling.
Ponekad da vidimo slike swamis koji drže cvijet i smješkaju se.
And if anybody ever comes to them, they say, "All right, God will bless you. God will bless you."
I ako im itko priđe, oni kažu, "U redu, Bog će te blagosloviti."
And people think, "Oh, very nice thing."
I ljudi misle, kako to je neka fina sveta osoba.
But actually, he doesn't care for the people at all.
Ali zapravo ga uopće nije briga za ljude.
He's just cutting a profile of being a saintly person.
Jednostavno izigrava svetu osobu.
Making a show. Making a show.
Pravi
of it. He's fulfilling the role that people expect a saintly person.
Radi show, to jest igra ulogu kako ljudi očekuju svetu osobu.
I remember once in Bangladesh, I was sitting with one so-called guru.
Sjećam se kad sam imao u Bangladešu sjedio s jednim takozvanim guruom.
Guru by profession.
On je bio guru po zanimanju.
That means people come to him for blessings and they give him donations.
To znači da mu ljudi dolaze za blagoslove i daju mu donacije.
This way he maintains his family.
I na taj način on održava svoju obitelj.
So an old lady came to him.
Tako mu došla jedna stara gospođa.
He said, "Oh, my eyes are very bad."
I rekla, "O, moje oči su jako loše, slabe."
He said, "Don't worry, God will look after you."
I mi rekao, "Ne brini, Bog će se pobrinuti za tebe."
Such a rascal.
Takav nitko.
Why should he speak such nonsense?
Zašto bi govorio takve gluposti?
You should tell her that you now you're very old, of course your eyes are bad.
Treba reći, pa stara si, naravno da su ti oči loše.
Take this as a sign that you're going to die soon.
Uzmi to kao znak da ćeš uskoro umriti.
So better chant Hare Krishna.
I zato bolje pjeve Hare Krishna.
So, but instead, "Oh, don't worry, God will help."
Ali mjesto toga, "Oh, ne brini, Bog će ti pomoći."
So people like to hear this.
Ljudi to vole čuti.
People like a sadhu who is always smiling and whatever you say, yes, yes, that's okay. Everything's all right.
Ljudi vole sadhu koji se smješka i što god kaže, tam kaže da, da, sve je u redu.
But that is not the actual business of sadhu.
Ali to nije stvaran posao sadhu.
Sadhu should help others.
Sadhu treba pomagati drugima.
Help means he may point out the defects.
Pomoć znači da može istaknuti greške.
He cannot do that unless he himself is free from defects.
Ali to ne može činiti ako sam nije oslobođen od tih greška.
That is why people will approach a saintly person.
I zbog toga će se ljudi ljudi pristupiti svetoj osobi.
A saintly person means he's supposed to be in a different class to materialistic people.
Sveta osoba znači da bi trebao biti na drugom nivou nego materialistički ljudi.
Because he's controlled his senses.
Jer je on kontrolirao svoja osjetila.
He knows how to say no to the senses.
Zna kako mu treba reći ne.
Everyone in the every materialistic person is dragged by the senses.
Svaku materialističku osobu vuku osjetila.
If there is something attractive to the senses, they will immediately, just like a fish going towards the food on the hook, they don't think. They just immediately go for it.
Ako nešto privlači osjetila, onda će to krenuti prema tome kao što riba automatski ide prema nešto hrane obješene na udicu. Ona uopće ne razmišlja o tome.
They have no sense of discrimination.
Nemaju nikakav osjećaj diskriminacije.
If it feels good, do it. That is about the limit of any philosophy.
ограничение готово всяке философии в модерном добу е, ако ќе бити добро, идите направи то.
This is a foolish so-called philosophy.
Тоа е глупа такозвана филозофија.
Because if something feels good and you do it, but then there may be a bad reaction afterwards.
Ако нешто изгледа да ќе бити добро, запрво лошо, ако има лошу последица.
Just like the fish, he sees the bait on the hook